Welcome, welcome, welcome to Sunday morning pay for play time. What's up, Chris? What's up, John Feedy? Mr. Lumen, Adrian, Collins here, Jeff is here. Who else is here? Sasha's here, kind of chilling out, looks like. So the regulars are in the house, so that means we can get started. As you can see, I'm pretty tired because I went to bed late last night. Not going to tell you why. But that's okay, because a quick story. We kind of only got half of our stimulus check and we're waiting for the other half, but we know it's coming. I finally got my freaking refund after 2.5 months after I turned my taxes in. And as you can see, oh, can you see it? Yes, this is some coffee. So when we got some money, obviously we were like, okay, we gotta be strategic about what we're gonna spend it on. You know, we got a new house. We wanna make sure we decorate, because we literally have the whole basement, which is done. We have a whole room up here in the second story, where I'm in, that is completely empty because we don't have enough money to buy stuff to put it in. So we gotta be strategic about what we buy, but my wife was 100% dead set on getting a coffee machine. And of course, you can't just get any coffee machine. You have to get like a good coffee machine, espresso machine. So we dropped $650 on I think it's called Breville. It's like the Breville. Does anybody else drink coffee? I don't. I'm not a coffee drinker. But she's been making these for me every, you know, this is basically just a latte. Yeah, so this will wake me up a little bit. We're putting it to good use. It's the Breville 720 or something like that. So it's a really, really good. It does make the house smell good, but that was, for me, that was quite, I was like, okay, this is what you, this is your one choice that you get, meaning like where I don't have any say. So yeah, I'm not a coffee drinker, but I'm trying to taste it a little bit, because usually I can't stand the taste of just regular coffee. It's too strong or whatever. So I put a bunch of shit in it. So it's like kind of defeats the purpose of it anyway, because then it becomes like, you know, a high caloric intake. But this one is literally strong, and we put some of this, I don't know, she's got this like Korean candy stuff in there that makes it kind of sweet. So this will make me up. This will wake me up. All right, so today is only Mr. Adrian. Adrian's in the chat. Adrian, say hi to everybody so that everybody can shit on you or praise you, depending on what song choices you have picked for them. So Adrian has picked five songs for us today that we are going to listen to and go through. Adrian is pretty good, along with a newcomer, Cliff, at picking songs that it seems like a lot of people like, not just me, and give some people some new bands they haven't thought about before. But again, this is not a competition. This is just allowing people to get their suggestions in and stuff like that. So we are gonna start off with, let's see, what was his first suggestion? This song is by Soen, who Soen has quickly moved up into my top five, because their songs are just freaking awesome. But this song is called Pluton. He said this is from an older, it's an older song, and it's a little heavier. So this is gonna be a heavier side of Soen, because the ones I've listened to tend to be more, you know, kind of straightforward, and they have heavy riffs, but the heaviness is not like the focal point. So we'll see. He says this is heavier. So here we go with some Soen. Okay. Nice bass sound there too. Nice stop. Hey, you guys can hear me, right? I fixed the voice, I think. Tell me you guys can hear me. Is the balance good? Tell me the balance good. Like that. Yeah, I thought the pause was me doing something wrong too, but I didn't touch anything. Ooh, I like that. Thanks, guys. I like this part a lot. That sounds like a Tool a little bit. Oh, that slowed down. That really sounds like Maynard a little bit. Yes. Ooh, I like that. Not too late. Yes. See, this is what I like about Soen, is when they go into these little, like, chill parts. See, this is a great song, Adrian. Good first pick. Dude, Soen's going up in my top four. Yeah, I can hear the Opeth. Like progressive Opeth in this too. I swim against the sea. Because here's the beat. But they're throwing it around a little bit. Yes. See, that is not lazy writing, people. I think I agree with Colin. I would like there to be more of a hook in this song, but it's still strong enough without one that I'm still liking it a lot. I feel like the sound of the double bass, the drum, bass drums sound kind of like the Metallica kind of sound from old. Like Dire's Eve, Metallica. Yeah, I agree, Colin. I think their switching between the two is really, really well done. You left like a last intervention. swim against the tide. Great use of flow in the lyrics and delivery. Coming to your side, leave my life now. Putting out the lights that shine on my life. Say on my lights. Fuck yeah, man. What the do? All right, man. That was, wow, really good. That's an, I don't think there's a Sewin song that I haven't even thought was just okay. I think they've all been pretty good. So, Adrian, I think, at least when looking at the chat, most people agree that was a good song. Maybe not the best song by them, but definitely a very good song and strong song. I think after this, guys, I might have to make a change. I think I might put these guys ahead of Carnival. At the number four spot. So, yeah, that's really tough though, because I feel like Carnival hasn't been on this channel for a while. So if you're a Carnival fan, I think you need to bring them back so that we can kind of have a battle between, because Sewin has just been really strong since we started listening to them the last month or so. I think Chris had it perfect, what he said. They do a good job at like mixing parts, especially with the choral kind of sound in the background, the harmonies and the voice parts in the back, and like the smooth, and like it had a good balance of the heavy and the smooth, and it provides this wonderful atmosphere, which is also one of the things I like about Carnival, is like their atmospheric feel. And so they might be up in the top four spot, which, by the way, I don't know if you guys know this, do you guys know any background on Sewin, like where they're from? Do they tour the United States, or have they toured the United States? Do they like tour with somebody, or are they the headliner, or are they like the backup? I would be interested, because when we start going to concerts again soon, I definitely want to be looking for these guys, because I would love to see these guys live as well. I mean, just a freaking, that was a great song. Good choice, Adrian. All right, so let's move on. Have you heard Dead Man by Vool? No, I have not. I have not heard that, so. All right, so let's move on to the next one. The next one is No Man's Land by The Pineapple Thief. I have never done them before in this channel, no, but I guess this is Gavin Harris's band that he's in now. Well, this is like more prog rock and not metal. Hey, that's right up my alley. I think Gavin Harris is a fucking sick-ass drummer. He's one of the best. So this is going to be What is the thing with like bands coming up with stupid names? The Pineapple Thief? Come on, you can come up with a better name than that. Alright, so this is The Pineapple Thief. This is called No Man's Land. No Man's Land. So let's see if we like this one. Like the start so far. Hope this doesn't get blocked. Well, I feel like I'm on the road. Good. Dressed in colors we were born, but did I hold you close? Okay, I need to fix this. And Lord only knows if you're happy now. There we go. And Lord only knows where you are. I like this. It's got like a Western feel to it so far. Look at me now in no man's land. Waiting for the sun to return. Yes. Sounds like very Eagles to me. Like an Eagles feel. I like that minor chord there. Takes away your time and lights the scorched stuff beyond return. I didn't hold you close. Lord only knows. This is a sad song, seems like. So there's a relationship break. Picture reminds me of the Wonder Years. Best drama ever on fucking television. But look at me now, Kevin! No man's land, waiting for the sun to return. Ooh. Like that. Dude, this song is fucking awesome so far. Great part. I totally see the Steven Wilson comparison here too. I mean, this is totally something I could hear by Steven Wilson. We haven't heard him a long time on this channel. Dude, this song is sick. Got such a great feel to it that's unique. Nice, Gavin. Good fills there. Tasty. God, I love this so much. This is a great song, guys. Good, like, feel. Adrian, you are 2 for 2, brother. Man, you are good at this. Wow. That was a great, great song. See the comparisons to Steven Wilson. Like, I think that even sounded a little bit like Steven Wilson. Wow. Very good. I think my favorite song still by Steven Wilson is the first one I ever heard from him, which was Home Invasion number 9, I think is what it was called. Can't believe I fucking remember that. I don't remember any titles, but that tells you something because, man, I really like that song by them. Him or them, whatever it is, because he does so many freaking different projects. But that was, I'm definitely putting, we are 2 for 2 here, Adrian. You're living up to your past. And these both are going to go on a playlist immediately. It was a little short, which I hardly ever say. I think in the genre that we all like and listen to, songs are rarely ever too short. They're usually mostly long. But I don't think it should have been much longer. I think it was a good package. So great job. Let's move on to the third one. This third one is called Ain't That a Bitch by 12 Foot Ninja. It's kind of a funny name. I wouldn't call it a bad name, but 12 Foot Ninja would be a scary motherfucker. Except you probably wouldn't see him because you'd just be dead if he's a ninja. So, or maybe it's a she. I don't know. I'm not into that bullshit. It's a he. All right, so Ain't That a Bitch by 12 Foot Ninja. I don't think I've ever heard this band either, so we're gonna find it. Here we go. Ooh, cool. Da, 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 da. Will it ever get better than this? If it ever gets better than this? If it ever gets better than this?
of here.
One, two.
'Cause I've done everything I couldn't.
Yes.
Everything I wouldn't.
What's the deal with Aussie bands being fucking awesome? Ain't that a bitch? No. No being a bitch? Is that what that means? Like no smoking?
Spinning poison with a
yes.
Stand your race of six by raising your fist. I could waste my time on giving a shit. I'm walking out.
I love lyric videos, people. Thank you for lyric videos like this. Love this song.
Without you, I wouldn't have found my strength.
Without you, I wouldn't have found my strength. I love how it's just a middle finger. Through your abuse, I learned to love myself. Oh no, I'm getting a copyright feel. Shit. Shit, I'm getting a copyright feel, guys. It's saying warning, warning, this might go down. Here we go, I'm gonna change this shit.
Will it ever get better than this? If it ever gets better than this?
Like this part. Yes, connection went back to excellent. See, I like this part. And I guess it's cool that I get the connection between these two parts and then the heavy part that we just got through. But I didn't like the heavy part all that much. I do like these parts. I wish the whole song was this. But I understand, I think from what I saw the lyrics, why they did that. And as Max says, if they're a parody band, especially with a name like 12 Foot Ninjas, they're trying to be cute and funny. Say it like that. All right, so... I would say definitely the first half of the song I liked, and I actually, if it would have stayed that way, I think through the whole song, I would have liked it. I didn't like the heavy part, and I think that's where, at least when I watch the comments, that's where it kind of lost some people. But again, like from the part of the lyrics that I read, it seemed pretty serious, like I grew from your abuse and I learned how to love myself from your abuse, which I would say with that feel, the lyrics didn't really match that. To me, those lyrics would have matched the heavy part better. So my one critique, now again, I didn't watch all of the lyrics or pay attention to the lyrics the whole time, but just in that little part, I'm like, okay, that kind of serious lyric shouldn't be matching. I think that would more match like a heavier or sad or minor key or something like that. So I would say that song was okay. I didn't dislike it, but I didn't like it. If it would have kept the beginning and end parts, I think I would have said I like that song. The second thing I just learned is in the middle of it, I just got a warning. The video and the music audio is a copyright. So I think I was ready to get blocked. But what I did was I put that stupid Luma key kind of filter on it, and within a minute it like went back to excellent condition. So in the future, I think I'm gonna try this. I will try to play videos the way they are, and so I can see the actual video and you guys can too. And then if I get that little warning pop up, I'm gonna try to quickly go to the Luma key filter and try to put that on it real quick so we can get back to it, because I could do that really quickly. All right, so it was a good learning experience on the editing end, so that's good. All right, so we're gonna move on to the fourth song. This fourth song, which I wanna say this before we move on to the fourth song. That being an Australian, or no, was that an Australian band? Because somebody said in the comments that was an Australian band, because the next one is an Australian band. Another one. So, actually, no, that was an Australian band, not the next one. The next one's a Canadian band. I think I just looked at it wrong. Okay, so yeah, if that was an Australian band, then I really think that Australia is going to have to get the key of like the new Seattle. I guess it wouldn't be new, but it seems like every band from Australia is just kicking actual awesome shit. So what is it about Australia that's pulling out all these awesome bands like this? So I'm definitely happy with it. I'm going to have to maybe go to Australia and just kind of like, are they all in the same freaking city like Melbourne, or where are they? Because I'm going to go just to visit all these fucking bands. So yeah, let's move on to the next one, which is Drowning in the Flood. Does anybody know what Drowning in the Flood? Who plays Drowning in the Flood? You should if you're a fan of them. I have not heard this. I guess this is from the debut album. So Drowning in the Flood. Any guesses besides Adrian? Who this band is? The song title was called Drowning in the Flood. Uh-oh, Jeff has got it. Haken. So here we go with some Haken. You guys know Haken is my first/second favorite band on this channel. So here we go. Oh shit. Perth, Brisbane, Sydney. How do you say Canberra? Canberra? Well, I guess I'm gonna have to go to Australia to go to all those places to hang out with these people. So here we go with Haken. I think if I remember correctly, Aquarius was an album that I didn't love some of the songs at the beginning, but we'll see if this is a great song that we love. Here we go, Haken. Yes, I like it so far. Very different sound for Haken singing. Yes. Liking it so far. His voice sounds different. Not there, okay. Bass sounds good. Drowning in the Flood. Oh. sounds awesome. Very kind of unique for Haken for me. The singing specifically. Very like rock and roll-ish, bluesy. Yes. Good transition right there. Dude, I love this heaviness. Okay, now I hope we get back to a hook. Dude, is this like Disturbed all of a sudden? Straight out of Lies. Lots of great riffs in this song. Feels a little disconnected. But this is kind of similar to the front, so same riff. Good transition there. That bass is doing some sick, good chord structure stuff. Transitions are on point. Cohesiveness, not as much. So we'll see where this goes. I mean, we fucking have 5 minutes left in the song still. I love this part. Kind of reminds me of the same sound of when Dream and Day unites, the Killing Hand. That, it's like the beginning of Killing Hand with the rain. Great, like, middle section here. Love that. Yes. Fuck yes. It fills my life. Dude, I love his voice. It's not too late to suffocate the price I will pay. The word I die. We are trapped. Beautiful. Yeah, Max, the bass to me sounds like almost like a fretless. worth the price we pay. I love that. I got a tear. I got a little bit of a tear. Or are we drowning in the flood? Fucking A. Woo! Oh, it sounds very Dream Theater-ish. Dude, I definitely cried a little bit. Barry Jordan feel. Yeah, I can see that, Jeff.
Whoa.
All right. Woo! Yeah, that definitely got me teary-eyed in that part, man. Oh, that was epic. Oh, that was fucking epic. Oh. Great song choice. That I think that was a 10-minute song that went by pretty quick. That Drowning in the Flood, I want to look back at those lyrics because I liked a lot of what I heard when I could hear it. And it just kind of added to the like feel of like contemplating like what's going on. Man, that was a great, great song. Holy crap. That's why they're my number one, number two band. Tied with Caligula's Horse right there. Yes, as some of you were saying, will he like the end? I'll be honest, I think it would have been better if they would have gone out on that epic part and just kind of like faded it maybe. I think would have been better, but I wouldn't say the ending is something I disliked. And I guess I'd have to look, you know, to see why they ended it like that, because Haken never does anything by accident. So I'm sure that there was some sort of connection to Drowning in the Flood, kind of a feel like a kind of thing. I don't know. But yeah, I'm gonna go back and think about it. So, man, wow, Adrian, good choice. I you know, think I remember people saying I didn't like Aquarius or I wouldn't like Aquarius as much. Is that the one? What's the one that, I guess, I thought Aquarius was the one that had more carnival sounds on it. Maybe not, maybe I'm mixing up with a different album that they have. But either way, fucking yes, that was, that was good, that was good. Going on a playlist, Adrian. So we're going to get to this last one. This last one is Celestial Violence by, I think it's Issan. And this one's featuring Einar. Is it Einar? Einar? I always get that wrong. Einar? I think it's Einar. The Leper Singer. And it says here that Issan is a solo act from the lead singer of black metal pioneers, Emperor, is the band name Emperor. And I guess this is Einar's brother-in-law? That's kind of interesting. He sings his solo materials more on the progressive side. Okay. So this is going to sound like progressive side. So we got two brother-in-laws together, and we'll see with this last song. I've never heard of this guy before, so we'll see if we like it. Hold on a second, let me take this down. All right, so here we go with Isan. I think it's how you say it. Isan. Here we go.
Unforgiving words into a star.
You can tell it's Einar.
Stay. This scenery would change if we could watch it from afar. Pain. Like icons of our suffering distilled to works of art. Pain. A sting of life to bind us to these heavens torn apart.
Oh. Nice and epic. Is that Einar singing that? Never heard Einar, I think it's Einar, scream. Einar. I would say that kind of conjunction between that really crazy part and then this is good. Like, I can understand it. I feel it. Okay. Ooh. I like that. Sasha, I agree. Like, I don't like screaming, but I felt like that fit more than normal stuff that I hear. And it wasn't for too long. Like this drum part here.
But strike a chord of dissonance when harmony betrays to lure you blind into the light.
Cool switch there. Good harmony there. I like that. That's memorable. Oh, good. The screaming is tasteful in this song. It's not too bad.
Oh,
All right, so that song I think is very well put together, makes a lot of sense, very well done. And again, you guys know I'm not a screamer, but I think that that was tastefully done and definitely didn't turn me off. I would say the song as a whole is probably one of those, okay, I appreciate it, it was good, but I probably wouldn't like listen to it on my own again. It probably wouldn't be like something I go, oh, I want to hear that song again. But it was well done. I liked it. I would say it was kind of like a good song. But yeah, definitely something not like very memorable, very hooky, I guess I should say. It wasn't a huge hook, but I did like the parts and the pieces that, and how they put them together. I like the repetition of that dun 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 dun. Very good. That part was memorable. I like how it went back from like that kind of section to this kind of section. So that was good, just not something I would be like, oh, I want to hear that again. So if it came on, I would like it. That actually brings me to another point before we end today's stream, is that for those of you who are going to request or suggest more than one song, or typically five songs, so you get a whole video yourself, my suggestion is this. Now, obviously, you don't have to do this, but my suggestion is this. Dan started this. Dan said, can you please put the songs in this order? So then I put, you know, and I think that that would be another cool piece for those of you who are doing this, because I think it's not only about like the songs that you pick, but the order in which I listen to them. You know what I mean? Just kind of like a concert. In a concert, they tend to end with an epic song, right? They start with a song that's gonna get everybody on their feet. Then they have some middle stuff. I mean, basically five songs in a video is like a mini concert. So I would suggest if you want to in the future, start like not only give me the links and background of the songs and stuff, but try to put them in an order that you want me to listen to them, and I'll try to make sure I put those in that order, okay? Sound good? Yeah, I'm gonna say for today, I know Sasha said the Haken song was the best for him, but he already knew it. I would say for me, it's a tie between the Haken song and the So-and song. I really, really like that So-and song, but the Haken song made me cry a little bit, so it's hard to beat that, you know? So yeah, we have a bunch of pay for play still left to do. We will be here tomorrow night, on Monday night. So make sure you're here for that. Otherwise, we will see you next weekend, and I will have hopefully, you know, a whole nother list, because we are definitely backed up with a bunch of pay for plays, but I look forward to more of these. I'm liking these, like, I mean, we basically just had 3 days of one person choosing the five songs, and I like that. It's kind of a cool thing for us to all kind of watch and be a part of. So, hope you guys have a great Sunday for the rest of you. Some of your Sundays are almost over, and we will be able to see you on Monday night. Be here at 7:30, y'all, Eastern Standard Time. All right, peace.